I'm gonna send this slice of pizza to space.
3, 2, 1!
And if I can bring it safely back down to Earth, I'm gonna eat it.
Oh my god, what?
This spacesuit is real, but unfortunately, I won't be traveling up with the pizza. But luckily, I've got some help to make sure it gets safely there and back. These guys are from a company called Sent Into Space. I reached out to them after watching these astronauts have a pizza party in space. I felt left out. And after nearly a year of phone calls, strategy meetings, calculations, flight path simulations, designs, and 3D printing, all around the concept of how to get a slice of pizza to space and back so I could eat it. Here we are on launch day. Time to head to the launch site. While the team finalizes our launch prep, I'm gonna prepare the pizza. I'm taking the recipe right out of my new cookbook, Knife Drop. It's a grilled pizza, the best I've ever had. First step, we have to roll out our dough. I haven't made pizza at a space launch site before, so this is gonna get messy. Nice and thin.
Okay, fill team on the balloon. Nick has started the pizza, so let's get this balloon filled within 10 minutes. We haven't got much time. Tech team, you know what you need to do.
Grill's nice and hot. We're gonna go right on with our pizza dough, and then we give it a few seconds to get some nice grill marks on the bottom. While our dough heats up, I'm gonna chop up some my herbs.
Launch team, we are going to have to increase hydrogen flow rate. We need to have that balloon flight ready ASAP.
It's puffed up. That's exactly what we're looking for. Next up, we'll flip, then add our three cheeses, fontina, romano, and a nice sprinkle of parmesan. Then on with a few dollops of tomato sauce. And because pepperoni is the most popular topping, a few slices of pepperoni. We'll finish it with just a little bit of basil and close it down.
Jeff, Nick, how are we looking pizza-wise? As you can see, we're getting close. We're probably about halfway through the fill. I'm hoping you've got about 5 minutes left of cook time.
Perfect. We'll finish the pizza off with a nice drizzle of olive oil and a good pinch of green onions across the whole pie. Our pizza's done. Perfection. It's time to slice into our pizza. Oh, that's a good sound. To place it into our launch vehicle.
Chef Nick, the balloon is filled. We have a very finite window of opportunity with our clearances, okay. And a weather front is on the way. Please tell me you've got a piece
of pizza.
Great. Its taxi is ready.
They're attaching the pizza right now, and as you can see, I'm also sending my new book, Knife Drop, to space as well, but I'll explain that later. For now, like the video and subscribe, and you'll automatically be entered to win a signed copy. Fingers crossed the pizza actually stays onto there, right?
I'm pretty confident in our attachment methods. We spent a long time thinking about how we were going to attach the pizza to the thing.
No way.
This food is difficult, man. I mean, I don't need to tell you, I'm sure. Making food look sexy.
We've got a squirter, folks.
What did she say?
Big question is, are you prepared to eat it when it comes back down?
If it's back safely, I'll eat. Yeah. The pizza's secured and we're about to launch. This right here is our launch vehicle, which was built custom just for this launch. On the YouTube community page, I asked all of you to agree on a name for our launch vehicle. Sam said whatever your retired cutting board was named. Khaled suggested we name it Manny so we can fire him up into space. And Andrew had a Toy Story reference that I truthfully didn't understand.
What? What are you talking about?
But the winning answer was to name it Pesto in honor of our hero.
We got some stickers for you.
Perfect. These are beautiful. I don't even know which one to pick. Maybe I'll pick one on each side. Oh, that looks so good. That's great. All right, should we launch this thing? It's finally time to launch. They're gonna lift the balloon up in the air, which is filled with hydrogen. Please bring this pizza back in one piece. All right, 3, 2, 1. Go!
Oh, wow. Wow.
Oh my Woo. Gosh, that is fast.
And there it goes, man.
Whoa, I've never seen anything like that.
Pizza is on its way into space.
Wow, good job.
Well done, buddy.
That was great. That's crazy. I can barely see it anymore, and it's only been a few seconds. As the balloon floated up further and further into the sky, I couldn't help but think of all the amazing memories we've had this year. We ate Gordon Ramsay's food in both Las Vegas and London for a delicious but expensive 24 hours straight. We cooked for Yama, the world's heaviest sumo wrestler, and then almost died in Bali when a flash flood hit us during an ATV trip. We spent several days testing out 100 different viral food hacks, cooked steak 50 different ways with Max the Meat Guy, and I even had a cooking challenge against Manny. Didn't you win?
Yeah.
I made Gordon Ramsay's beef Wellington while blindfolded, met my sworn enemy, Salpe, who turned out to be a friend, met up with the one and only Tom Brady for a video, and made chili with the legendary Kevin Malone from The Office. We even gave somebody a brand new car, did a campaign with Mr. Beast where we donated 10 million meals, failed to make a gigantic dumpling with Uncle Roger,
this was the my divorce.
Broke not one, not two, but 7 Guinness World Records, and yes, Manny was fired on a number of occasions, but just kept coming back.
You're fired. Get out.
You're fired.
Get out of my car. You're fired.
You're fired, Manny.
Manny, you're fired.
And sadly, we lost our beloved hamster Pesto, which brings us to this. Our vessel Pesto had reached its destination. As I look at this pizza fly through Earth's atmosphere, looking down on the entire world beneath it, I want to thank all of you. We wouldn't be up here without you. Though he doesn't know it, this is also a special moment for Pesto. It gives him the proper send-off he always deserved. And I can now finally tell you that I did all of this to say one thing. The recipes in Knife Drop are out of this world. Literally. Somebody that pre-orders in the next 3 days is getting this exact book, signed and straight from space. Go pre-order. The view was breathtaking, but I was hungry, and it was time to bring the pizza back to Earth.
Blue just burst. We've got to go now.
Minnie, get the rental car. Go, go, go.
Nick, I got the car. Get in.
What?
Minnie, why did you get a Rolls Royce?
It's the only option they have left.
Yeah, I'm looking for a rental car. What's the most expensive one you have? I'll take it.
Our pizza is currently zooming down through the stratosphere, plummeting back down to Earth, reaching a peak descent speed of almost 200 miles an hour. And now we are on what we call the chase. Hello?
Nick, we are at 27 kilometers, and I need you to update your location. We're heading for Walton-on-the-Wolds.
Walton-on-the-Wolds?
Walton-on-the-Wolds, yeah.
What kind of name is that?
We should be about 5 minutes ahead of it if we move fast now. If you are ready to open up the engine on that Rolls Royce, it is time to get moving, because we have a chance of catching this as it comes down.
How fast can this thing go?
You take it to my speed.
Oh, he wants to go.
We're going 120 miles an hour.
We're driving as fast as we can right now to make it to that pizza when it lands. We are literally driving through empty countrysides in England.
We get there now, and we just got stuck behind a bunch of horses in the middle of the countryside.
Weather car, this is Puff Daddy.
We hear you, over.
We took the wrong exit.
We saw you peel off, over.
We're going as fast as we can. We'll be there soon. Puff Daddy out.
Puff Daddy.
Are you guys there? I can't hear you.
Space Wagon to Puff Daddy. Can you hear me? Over.
Did you just change it down?
No. Come in, Puff Daddy. Come in, Puff Daddy. This is the Space Mobile. We've lost Nick.
Puff Daddy, weather car, do you copy?
Coordinates have just changed. We are relocating. I need new coordinates.
We're going as fast as we possibly can. I think we're a few minutes behind you, but we're going to try to pick up some speed.
This pizza is going to be absolutely freezing when we get this back.
We should be pulling up now. We have to be ready to run.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Jesus Christ. That's Jason Bourne.
Everything's telling us around this corner.
It's in the middle of nowhere. If the pepperoni fell off, I'm gonna be so mad. It's there, it's there. Whoa, whoa. Is it frozen?
Pretty frozen, yeah.
Oh, it's cold. Whoa.
You did it, man.
It's here.
Nice
Good
work,
job.
Nice work,
oh my God.
All the way from space.
I can't believe it. This actually went to space. That's crazy. The pizza looks fantastic. The main prize here today was the pizza right there. And look at it. It's just a nice, perfect slice of pizza. So the pizza was at a negative 125-ish Fahrenheit up top.
Yeah.
Oh, God. And the book has a little bit of mud on it, but it made it safe as well. I'm going to go ahead and sign it right now. And this exact book is going to be one of yours, so go pre-order now for a chance to win it.
Nick, you're forgetting something.
There's only one thing left to do. I promised I'd taste this pizza. Oh, it's so cold. Space pizza.
Does it taste as good as it looks?
Or sandy. It almost tastes a little smoky though. It's delicious. Thank you again to the whole Sent Into Space team for helping me send this slice of pizza to space and back. And thank you to all of you. Happy New Year. Pesto made it back down to Earth. We love you, Pesto.